was contacted by Mr. Ruhul from London, and we had a brief chat over email, and then he came to India, and then we had a nice meeting with each other, and he explained me the story. It is an epic story, around 160 years old, about a guy called Hason Raja. He was a legendary poet, and once we started discussing, you know, and through the process, I also came to know that Ruhul is one of the first guys in London, in that area, an Indian maybe, or the Asian, who basically started martial arts in that area. So there was an instant connect with Ruhul, with me, and he told me that there is a fighting sequence in this movie, and he wanted to create a legend through martial arts. And that was, you know, a very interesting factor for me, because, you know, I'd been dreaming to do something like this, you know, and especially because he himself is a martial artist, he can bring out the similar kind of, you know, choreography or similar kind of visualization which I wanted to portray. So it was really interesting. You know, around 15, 20 years of watching Hindi movies and stuff, the way action is generally made in India is not up to the mark if it is compared to the Hollywood style, you know, as far as the finesse is concerned, as far as moments are concerned. One idea which was very common between me and Ruhul was that you need to create special moments, you know, which gives goosebumps to the audience, you know, or special acts which are not completely related with martial arts, but it is martial expressions. That is one thing which you don't see in the movies, you know. All action films without a strong storyline or without a strong emotion and martial expressions are useless. And that was one thing which I thought that in this movie, I'm going to add on the real essence of Shaolin and, you know, the Japanese martial arts. I've been training for around 25 years now in martial arts. And this is what I thought. Few moments, few handheld shots, very fast-paced combat system, because it is all about sword, which is about speed, power, timing, accuracy and precision. And these things I wanted to show in the combat. And since Hason Raja himself is a very legendary figure, you know, so a legend has to be portrayed like a legend. So his swordsmanship should prove that he is a legend, apart from being a poet. Because poetry and martial arts and music is just like same, you know. It's beautiful, yet it has a lot of impact if said and narrated in a very nice way. Because the only factor in my mind when we started shooting, Ruhul Dada told me that, you know, we have Mithun Da shooting in this film. Keeping his age in mind, I was a little apprehensive whether he'll be able to do it. But to my surprise, you know, he's been giving shots in one takes, you know. So I'm satisfied. I'm sure Ruhul is an award-winning director. He's a known director outside, you know. So I don't think there's a problem for him to promote his film. And from art, and now he's adding the glamour here. So I'm very much sure if the, and Mithun Da is also a very big star, you know. If the film goes into the Bangladesh and Calcutta and this, the Northeast region, it's going to be a great success, and abroad also. So, and we all are putting our best to make it. But the whole look of the film is very nice. Apparently, I just heard one song, and the day I went home, I was just humming that song non-stop, continuously. That is the beauty of a song. If you hear it once and you can hum it, that means it is a catch-up.